I'm Jodi DeJong-Hughes, soil scientist from the University of Minnesota Extension.
And I'm Jared House, administrative manager at the Grant County Soil and Water Conservation District. In September of 2020, we held the Soil Health Expo near Barrett, Minnesota on the Roloffson family farm. We wanted to look at how to use cover crops and reduce our tillage to minimize soil erosion and improve the health and productivity of our soils.
This is the second video in the series. In this video, we'll discuss fertility strategies when going to reduce till or no-till. Jared, what did we find out from Paul Groneberg and the farmer speakers?
Paul has been a crop consultant for many years, and he spoke about the fertility strategies when moving to a reduced or no-till system.
I can imagine that no-till has a few more challenges when trying to get the nutrients into the root zone. How have the farmers overcome this issue?
One of the biggest issues with reduced till, and especially no-till, is residue tie-up of nutrients. Not only can residue physically stop the fertilizer from getting into the soil, but can also tie up the nutrients within the residue. Paul explains that it's important to get the fertilizer below that layer of residue.
One option is put on as much nutrients as you can down with the planter. That's one of the advantages on a no-till planter. What's nice about the 2x2 is you can put on as much as you want and it doesn't bother the seed. The major limitation is how much you want to put on and how often you want to fill. But that's the most ideal.
University of Minnesota research and farmer experience has shown us that for strip till, up to 50% of the nitrogen can be banded while strip tilling. About 5 to 7 gallons of 1034-O can be applied with the planter, and the remainder can be applied as a side dress treatment. While injection of fertilizer below the layer of residue would be beneficial, some growers may not have the equipment to do this.
It's also important to use a urease inhibitor if nitrogen is going to be broadcast.
Good point.
Phosphorus can be tied up in the soil, especially on high pH soils where extra calcium is present, or in very low pH soils where aluminum and iron dominate. By band applying, less phosphorus is tied up and more will be available to the crop.
Getting phosphorus and potassium into the root zone also has its challenges. In a no-till system, the soils may be cooler and root growth can be slowed. Instead of broadcasting your nutrients on the surface, a starter at planting is beneficial so the roots can find the nutrients faster, and this will speed up crop growth.
Some people have said if you spread it on top, it'll eventually work down. I do a little spreading on top, and hopefully over time, I can get it to percolate down through the residue, but that's going to take time.
Potassium must be treated differently. If potassium is near the surface and the soils are dry, the roots will not be able to extract it. Banded potassium is a better option in a no-till or reduced till system. We recommend using a minimum of 40 to 50 pounds of potassium, even on our higher testing soils.
Sulfur is another important nutrient to consider. In a conventional system, sulfur is normally mineralized from organic matter. But in a no-till system, mineralization is greatly reduced, which leaves less sulfur available for the crop. For this reason, additional sulfur needs to be applied. Again, banded sulfur will be more available than broadcast. Basically, university research shows that banded nutrients are more crop available in heavy residue systems like no-till and strip-till.
That's right. There are multiple ways to put down nutrients instead of the one-and-done method. If you strip-till, put down a quarter to a half of your nutrients with the strip-till pass. Split the rest between planting and side dressing.
If you're no-till and you broadcast your nitrogen, make sure to use a urease inhibitor to get the most out of your nitrogen. So remember, your soil is your most valuable resource when growing a healthy and profitable crop. By planting cover crops, reducing your tillage, and managing your nutrients, you can improve the health of your soil and keep the nutrients in soil where they belong.
Yep, in the field where the crop can use them. In the following videos, we will look at the management involved when introducing cover crops and reducing tillage in our fields.